Welcome to clickmyproject.com. Here we are going to discuss about our project titled as Learning Discriminative Binary Codes for Large Scale Cross-Model Retrieval. Here we are going to see our abstract of our project. The image retrieval process includes retrieving the text that most closely matches a query image or retrieving the image that most closely matches a query text. It is shown that accounting for model correlations and semantic abstractions both improve retrieval accuracies. These tasks are central to many applications of practical interest, such as finding on the web the picture that the best illustrates a given text or a page of a story, finding the text that best matches a given picture, a search using a combination of texts and images. The major problem of the cross-model hashing is to analyze the binary codes that construct the underlying correlations between different features from different modalities. The recent approach fails to explore the discriminative property of class labels during hash function learning. The binary codes generated by these methods are suboptimal and less discriminative to different classes. In order to overcome the limitations, the novel cross-model hashing is proposed for image retrieval process. The scheme will directly analyze the discriminative binary codes while retaining the discrete constraints. The discrete constraints cross-model hash function, which utilizes the modality-specific hash function for generating the unified binary codes. And these binary codes are viewed as representative features for discriminative classifications with the pre-class labels. And the performance are analyzed by using the database set. Now let's see the flow diagram of our project. And the flow diagram, which consists of several models. In the first, the data set. The data from the data set, we are getting the input images. And then the pre-processing stage performed, and the channel separation stage is performed. After that, the segmentation is processed. From the segmentation, so we get the feature extractions. From that step, the images are retrieved, and that the binary codes are generated. And after that, we are collecting the retrieved images. At first, we are going to see about the input image stage. When the input images get from the data set, then the selected image is subjected for the pre-processing. The aim of pre-processing is to improve the image data that suppresses the unrolling distortions or enhances some image features important for the processing, although it geometric transformation of the images. The UI get fill function is to get the image from the data set. After getting that input image, the pre-processing step has been performed. In that stage, the input image is resized into 256 x 256 size images for the processing. Likewise, all the images in the dataset was pre-processed. The pre-processed image will have some noises which should be removed for the further processing of the image. Next stage is the channel separation stage. In that stage, the separation of the RGB channels for the three colors red, green, blue is used to analyze the component of the primary colors of each part of an image. If the RGB image is 24-bit, each channel has 8 bits for red and green and blue, where each image can store the discrete pixels with conventional brightness intensities between 0 and 255. The image will be analyzed in primary color components red, green and blue, so called the RGB colors. The image will be resized if it is too large to accelerate the calculations. Thus, in an image encoded in RGB, the white color corresponds to the presence of three colors simultaneously. The black color corresponds to an absence of three colors simultaneously. Let me consider a single slice of RGB image. A new RGB stack is created. The channel 1 is being the red channel, and channel 2 is the green channel, and channel 3 is a blue. The fourth slice is the merged slice. If a channel is empty, then the slice is omitted. After the channel separation stage, we are going for a segmentation. In the segmentation, a single object may be represented by two or more segments. In some of the cases, the opposite, the pixels belonging to different objects are classified as belonging to the same objects. A single segment may contain several objects, in which the segmentation partitions an image into distinct regions containing each pixels with similar attributes. To be meaningful and useful for image analysis and interpretations, the region should strongly related to the depicted objects or features of interest. And this is the segmented image. From that segmented image, we have extracted the features. In the feature extraction, it is a process to retrieve the most important data from the raw data. The feature extraction is finding a set of parameters that defines the shape of character precisely and uniquely. In feature extraction phase, each character is represented by a feature vector, which becomes its identity. The major goal of a feature extraction is to extract a set of features which maximizes the recognition rate with the least amount of element and to generate a similar feature set of variety of instances of the same symbols. After the feature extraction, we are going to retrieve the images by using image retrieval stage. In that stage, the images are searched by their general image description model representation. The model is based on similarity retrieval. The user interface supports the visual expressions of a query and allow the query refinement and manipulation of the results. The discrete cross-model hashing jointly learns the unified binary codes and the modality-specific hash function under the classification framework are proposed in this project. Hence, the learned binary codes are expected to be more discriminative than previous similarity-based approaches. An efficient discrete optimization algorithm, that is called a discrete cross-model hashing, to deal with the discrete constraints and to iteratively approximate the optimal binary codes bit by bit in a closed form, making the entire learning procedure very efficient to the large-scale data. And in the image retrieval process, the binary codes are generated, and we compare these binary codes for each image. The images are retrieved from the databases and it is stored. Then the collection of images are shown at the output. Now we see the running procedure of our project. If you want to run the project, just right click on the main file and run the process. And a dialog box is open and select the image to be retrieved. The data set consists of five set of images. One is the buildings and other is the animals, and third one is the mountain ranges, and fourth one is the food items. If you want to select any one of the items, just double click on it. And this is a resized image, and all the images are retrieved from the databases, which is similar to a selected image. Now the images which you have to selected, the retrieved images which is based on the similar image you have to selected, and these are the outputs which shows the output of the image. And this is the precision value of the obtained input image.